Hello friends, welcome all. Today in this webinar, we will be discussing about the making the most out of budget. Budget has always been the most important event in a trader's life because there have been many volatile sessions coming up. There are the trend changes happening during the budgets. So budget has always remained the key focus area if you term it from the investor perspective or a trader perspective. So our motive would be to see how we can use this budget for the making the best use of using the options. Also, the examples which we are using here are just an illustration purpose, and it's just an illustration. So you do take care of your entire research before taking any call. Welcome all. I'm Tina Gadoria. Let's begin. First, let's see what all we'll be discussing. The first would be the concept, followed by the decoding budget price expectations. Thereafter, we'll be discussing about the directional trading for budget. Post that, the volatility trading. Then, how you can hedge your portfolio in the budget season. And finally, about the Mumbai workshop. So let's start. So why is the budget more important? So historically, it's been seen that event trading has been one of the most preferred trading style, just not in India, but across globe. So you see the activity increasing during the result season or during the RBI policy or during the budget, because main reason being the many time frame, you can say almost all time frame participants come and take the call in this event season. So budget have always been in focus. If you talk about the fundamental analysis, fundamental people comes into place, technical people comes, and also in the option side. Now again, a smaller time frame people come into picture, they create their strategy. Even the larger time frame people come into because their portfolio is getting impacted. So this is the main reason why event trading has always been focused. So now when we know there is a lot of volatility happening during the event, so how should we take our bets? So once we understand how the positions are placed, and then let's see which all are the strategies which are best suited for such events. Because we need to play the volatility the way it is. So if we are expecting the surge in volatility or we are expecting the volatility to plummet, so in that case, we need to take a call on volatility and take a strategy. There are a host of strategies, almost 40 plus strategies which are available. But we should be knowing which type of strategy is best suited for any event. So basically through this webinar, I would be just focusing on few strategies which we can look out from the events perspective, especially the budget one. Also, there are other strategies. So it depends upon the completely on the risk profile of a person. So let's begin. I request one more thing, like Keith, for any questions, keep your questions towards the end. We'll have the Q&A sessions wherein you can write on the chat and we can answer accordingly. But please restrain yourself for asking the questions during the webinar. Now what happens in the budget one? So you all have seen like how the India VIX has gone up. So like it was trading near 1240 and suddenly now it is around 16.2. So this is something not very new. It's been the phenomenon every time. The short-term volatility leads to a panic among the participants. So like because if you're a portfolio holder, you get worried like what if something negative comes up on the budget? What if this is not given? So how will my price react? So the portfolio people also come into picture. The traders are always there, the speculators are there, even the medium time frame people come into picture. So this volatility creates a panic among us. The main motive for us is the how we can come out from this volatility in a more smoother manner. So first, let's begin. What is the budget price expectation? This is the chart which shows the budget day movement in the index. Okay. So I guess everyone can see the cursor. Yeah. So these are the budget day's value. Okay. So BD means the budget day. BD minus one, that means the first previous trading session. BD minus 2 means 2 days previous trading session. BD plus 1 means the next trading session, and plus 2 means followed by that. So this is the percentage change. So this basic column tells you how much the Nifty has gone up or down on a budget day. Mind you, this all seasonality graph may or may not work. So we cannot rely this completely. But this is for our reference to know that how the things have been in the past. Okay. So this could be one of your decision maker, but not the only one. Just a sec. Yeah. So we see that on a higher end, it has gone to 1.8%. In Feb, it went to minus 1.8%. And in between, it's like a half a percent between. So on a budget day, this is type of the movement which we see. So this is just to keep on the back of our mind. Fair enough. Now comes, this is the chart of India VIX. Okay. So we have plotted like budget day, how the volatility was and how it behaved. So every time we have seen that on the budget day, the volatility actually cools off. So you see that was a high in 2015 budget. The high went to 16.97 and then it closed at 16.69. Post that, the next 2 days it was again coming down. Next in 2016 we saw it was close to around 22 around, and then it closed at 19.36. Then in 17 the high was 17.43 and it closed at 13.64. Now we have seen today the India VIX has risen to 16.23. So this is again moving up to the upper end of 18%. So this 18% remains a very crucial point from the India VIX perspective, because it's been long, it has not crossed this level. So move beyond 18% can see a drastic rise in volatility, else again it can be a gyration. But the surge in volatility is on the expected line. It's something not really very new, because during the event, definitely the volatility picks up. Why it picks up? Because there are hedgers who want to hedge their position. So they buy the options. Similarly, there are the people who want to trade on either way's direction. So they buy the options. And also, once you see that the call IV has gone up, the put IV cannot be at the same level, because there is a something called as put call parity which prevails in the market. So both the put option price and the call option price are related to each other. So when you look at the volatility smile or anything, you actually can sense out how the walls are moving on the OTM side. So market is on the expected line solely, the walls are higher. So it's been the phenomenon in the past itself. Now, the easiest way to understand what could be the budget price expectation from a very layman perspective would be to find out what is the price of the at the money option, call and put. So once you have a at the money option, just see what is the price of the call, what is the price of the put. So this presentation, it's just not very real time, it's not today's price. Few examples were taken yesterday, few were taken today. So related based on the example side. So say for instance, the Feb Nifty was at 11,100 pre-budget. Okay. So on 23rd, that is yesterday, the 11,100 call and put were quoting around 183 and 182. So if I combine the premium of at the money, so because at the money options are the one which have the highest risk of coming into in the money, right? Because if suppose it at 11,100, it is at the money call. Once the market moves to 11,200, it becomes in the money. If the market moves to 11,000, it becomes out of the money. So this is the at the money options are the most sensitive on to the price movement. So taking the at the money option as a price reference becomes a very good judgmental tool. So yesterday it was quoting around 365, Nifty at 11,100. So the combined premium comes to somewhere around like 3.3%. Okay. So this is the wall, you can say this is the return, this is the movement which a trader is expecting. Now if I add the total premium, that is 365 on 11,100, that comes to 11,465, and if we deduct, it is comes to 10,735. So this is the band which is what the prices are looking out for. So we are looking out for a combined premium of which is 3.3%. Based on that, the upper and the lower band comes to 10,735 and 10,465. Fair enough. So it's, if you look at 3.3%, it is not really very high also and not very low also. So it's something which is above average, you can say that. So it's on the expected line. So when you have a higher total premium as a percentage of the price, that indicates there's a high volatility which has been expected. Okay. Similarly, when there is a lower percentage premium, that indicates a lower volatility expected. So now if we go back, 3.3%, so like on an average, we are expecting 3% movement up and down sort of, so which comes to a band of 11,500 to 10,700. So this is what the option prices are telling. Now, when you're taking up the strategy, do look out from what is the at the money at that point of time. So if it's tomorrow or Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, because the things would be changing. So take the look at the money option and then decide your course of action. Fair enough? Now, so budget, one more observation which has been that budget has historically led to a momentum accelerating. So what I mean to say by momentum accelerating, so like if supposedly market was on a down one, suddenly something happens in the budget and then you see a reversal. So there is a momentum accelerating on the opposite side. Now, second case, when the market was going higher, maybe couple of days it corrected minorly. Post budget again takes up the trend, but it takes up the trend very fast. So the acceleration in the momentum is there. So budget, one key point is like it's just not the budget day, one day before or one day after. If you look at the budget, it has the impact on the entire series. So when I say coming up with a strategy, so when you decide a strategy, is it only you're looking out from the first Feb perspective, or you're looking out for something to hedge yourself for maybe Feb series or maybe till 9th, 10th one? So deciding on the time factor is very important. So when you come up, when you do any optimizer, when you use the optimizer algorithm, so be clear on the what the date you are expecting, whether you're looking up on the strategy from the first Feb perspective or say 8th, 9th perspective or the expiry perspective. So be clear on that front. So the first thing, like even if you're doing for a bank Nifty or even if you're looking for any stock, look at what is the at the money options, combined premium quoting at, and then you add those premium on the call and put, you add to the call and subtract to the put to get the range. Fine. So this is where you can find out the price mechanism. You can find out how the what is there on the expected on the price front. Now in the next session, we'll talk about the directional trading for budget. At times it happens like we want to take a directional bet, but because there's an event lined up, there's a lot of anxiety. So we squared off our profitable trade also, or we get hesitant to take any new position. Fair enough, there's nothing wrong in doing that. But if you are very strong on your directional bet, then you can take up the strategies which are suitable for the directional bet, yet protecting yourself. So one thing is like when you are new to options, my recommendation won't be don't go naked option writing. Because if you are new, selling option at the right will be increasing your anxiety even more. So doing a strategy, selling the option in the combined framework, doing a strategy makes more sense from a beginner's perspective. Because when you will come to the workshop also, we'll understand like how option prices are impacted. Each and every variable like volatility, time, they are very much interrelated to each other. They are very much dependent on each other, I would rather say. Other than that, there are other Greeks also like a gamma or a delta. So when I say option selling, I'm just mean to say a naked option selling. If you're a beginner perspective, think because like there's a gamma short. So there could be a good risk coming up because in the option selling, your premium is limited, your return is limited, and your loss is unlimited. So just one word of caution, but yeah, if you're an advanced trader, you can definitely choose the strike. You can see the band and you can be taking the much more cushion and then look out from the writing perspective. Because doing a strategy that time involves a lot of study on the Greeks also. From the beginner perspective, we are not taking much on the Greek side. But yeah, when you come up on the, when you do an advanced thing in that, Greek's understanding becomes very crucial. Now, when I talk about directional trading from a bullish point of view, the what we can do is like a call ratio back spread and the call butterfly spread. So there are many other strategies also. So like you can expect, if suppose if you're expecting the walls to continue to rise, so maybe say it could be dropped sometime. And basically from the stock perspective, you can see if you expect that the walls could continue to rise, then that time you can do a ratio back spread, wherein your loss is limited and your profit, you have a good potential. If you're expecting the walls to subside or to be sideways, at that time you can do a call butterfly spread. Now, building up the strategy also is very important. Why? Because out of so many strikes, almost 40 plus strikes, selecting the best strike combination is something what a trader needs to look out for. So whether you are expecting that the market would be just range bound and not do anything, then you can build up the butterfly spread at the money option. But if you expect that the market could be bullish, say for instance, let's understand through the example. I take one by one. In the bearish one, you have the put ratio and the put butterfly. So let's first do with the call ratio back spread. So what exactly is a call ratio back spread? Ratio back spread or a bear call ladder is just not a synonyms. I will explain you the difference between both. So it's extremely bullish strategy that expects a relatively higher volatility in the stock. One sec. Yeah. So that expects a relatively higher volatility in the stocks. Or else you can say it expects a very sharp upward movement in the stock. So if the walls are rising, if you expect the wall should continue to rise, at that time you do this thing, ratio back spread. Or if you're expecting that the particular index or the stock can give you a return of say 5 to 6%, say from the index perspective, say it gives you a return of 5%, or from the stock perspective, it expects you to give a return of 10%. At that time also you can do a call ratio back spread. Preferably, call ratio back spread is good to initiate at the start of the series. Why? We'll come to know. So now how it is executed? So in a call ratio back spread is executed by selling an in the money option. So when you sell a in the money option, you get a premium, correct? And now you're selling in the money option, so you will get a relatively higher premium. Okay? So you're selling an in the money option and you're buying a higher strike option, two lots. So now it is, say for instance, you're selling a in the money option, you get a higher premium and you buy a upper end call wherein you have to pay the premium. You're buying two lots of that. Now what happens? Net, your net premium outflow is relatively lower because your in the money option which you have sold is at a higher price. Compare the one which you are buying the options. So net, your outflow is relatively lower, but it has its own advantages and disadvantages. Let's look at what it is. So your maximum profit in this strategy is unlimited if the stock moves beyond a higher strike call. Okay, so if it starts moving beyond the higher strike call, the one which you have bought it, so now you have two calls which you have on the upper hand. So your stock, your profit is unlimited beyond that price. So ideally, it is should be done when you're expecting the implied volatility is rising. It helps you to generate a sorry. It helps you to generate a relatively higher returns in the exponential uptrend. So wherein you are seeing the prices going higher by 10%, 15%, you're expecting that the stock can go to 15% higher. At that point, you can take this up, this strategy. Because if you're expecting that this movement can come up in the next 10 to 15 days, then it's apt for taking up such strategy because you are not getting impacted because of the theta decay. The maximum loss is at the buy strike. So what happens at the buy strike? the option which you have sold, in that you are making money, but the option which you have bought, that will expire zero. So net net, you're not making much, not making any money. So your maximum loss point is at the strike which you have bought the option at zero. So net net, you're not making much, not making any money. So your maximum loss point is at the strike which you have bought the option. And what is that thing? It's a difference between the strike plus the net outflow. Okay. So what call ratio back spread wants is, it wants a momentum. It wants a trend. So when you're expecting a good uptrend in a stock, that time it is a apt strategy to be done. So if you're expecting, say for instance, Nifty can scale up to 11,500, that time you can do such strategy. Okay. The strike selection becomes a key in this way. So now, say for instance, sorry, this is 110. So Nifty was 11,110. So you're selling 10,750 call at 420. So this was example was taken yesterday, okay? And you're buying 11,000 call at 245. So you have seen that it's in the money option. 10,750 call is a February series. So 420. And you bought 11,000, which was 245. So net net, your outflow is 70 points, correct? Now if I have to evaluate this strategy from 10th Feb perspective, so like see what, just not on the budget date, but say something more on beyond the budget day also, if I have to look out from the strategy perspective, how I will do it. So this was the payoff. Okay. So this is a snapshot which I have taken from the optimizer and manager, because it becomes very handy when you're evaluating the strategy. So here I have sold 10,750 call Feb and bought 11,000. So now my maximum profit is at 11,500, which is around 14,300. And at 10,700, my loss is around 7,900. Okay. Now, if you look at the payoff chart, so maximum loss happens near to 11,000 call, which is the option which we have bought it. Okay. And as you go lower, my loss starts reducing, because what happens? My option which I have sold, the call option which I have sold, that is also expiring worthless, so it is giving me money. Okay, so if suppose it goes below 10,750, so 750 call also becomes worthless, it becomes zero. So my loss gets set off because of that. So if you see, as you go lower, so if there is a wild movement expected, it's good for such scenario, because in that case, either your profit would be exponential or else your loss would be relatively lower. Correct? At 11,000, this area will look at for the maximum loss coming up. Okay. Now, if the prices goes higher, why we do this strategy is something like, I feel the Nifty can go to 11,500, but it is in a new zone altogether. Is it really necessary it can stop at 11,500 or it can go higher also? So basically, the main motive for doing a call ratio back spread is to make sure that I am in the uptrend. So the strategy is in the uptrend and it is helping us to make money. Okay, so we are not restricting ourselves on the target zone. So if the prices are showing some strength, then we can hold on to the strategy altogether. So I have a loss which is limited and a profit which is unlimited in this scenario. So it is ideal to play the directional momentum with a very strong pace. Now, if you look at one thing very well, you need to understand is this strategy, when you're saying I've decided to do it in say 10 to 15 days. So 10 to 15 days, you have the loss, which is this 7,000. But as the expiry comes closer, it will start behaving on the expiry based payoff. Okay. So this strategies, you need to be very particular in exiting also. You cannot hold on to this strategy from the till expiry. If the direction is in your favor, if you are seeing 11,000, say for instance, in our example, if we see 11,500 plus and that time we are holding on to strategy, definitely yes. But if we see that the prices are getting range bound, the index is just gyrating, it is not doing anything much, that point we need to exit the strategy, because as we come closer to the expiry, the theta decay will come up. So in if you take the case of the strategy per se, why you make good money in the strategy or why you don't make app money in the strategy, because of the timing factor. We create the strategy from the expiry perspective, but we exit it during the expiry, because we have not seen the P&L of that thing from the expiry during the expiry. So it's very important, like, what is your motive? If is your motive to hold on to the strategy from the expiry, then select the date as expiry only. But if your motive is to see the strategy from a short-term perspective, to use the time in the days to evaluate respective to the what is your forecasted date. Okay, because time plays a crucial point in the option pricing. Okay, because time plays a crucial point in the option pricing. Fair enough. This is called a call ratio backspread. Spread. So let's see how it is in the app. Strategy. Let's see how is the payoff today. I'll go to manager. I add position. So I do a predefined strategy. So in manager, you have a bifurcation of predefined and the customized also. So if you want to do some permutation with the futures, I buy a future, I sell a call, I buy a put. So in that case, you use the customized one. Okay, because futures are allowed in the customized one. Now, if you are selecting from the already building the strategies, you need to do the predefined strategies. So I go to Nifty, say next, this is a bullish one, I use all strategies, yeah, so I go to call ratio backspread, so my February series, okay, so say for instance, the example which we discussed, let's see how it is today, so 10,750 we sold and 11,000 we bought in, okay. So somewhere on that only. So you have 540. So I save this thing. Ratio backspread. Example. Okay. So it will get added to my position. And we can look out there. Just a sec. Yeah. So here is the strategy. Okay. So when you see on the manager, now when you're building up the strategy, so if you find the best strategy from the optimizer, use that strategy, you can export it to the strategy manager and you can use it. Now if you want to create your own strategy, then use the strategy manager, add position to see the strategy. Now you can see the entire risk profile, what is the margin stuff, what is the ATM walls quoting at. Then you can use the see the Greeks. So if you have gone to the earlier webinar, there was some discussion on this topic itself. So whether you are gamma long or gamma short, vega long or vega short, because trading strategy is a very in-depth topic. It's just not, we can cover it up in the 1 hour webinar. It goes the pricing, you need to understand the pricing and the stuff. But to keep the things simple, just make sure if you are a beginner, my recommendation would be personally, don't go for a gamma short strategy like a short straddle or a short triangle. But yeah, definitely if you are a intermediate trader to advanced trader, you can use those strategy because of taking the advantage of higher walls. Now when I analyze it, you can see this thing. So my motive is, say I want to see for 16 days. Okay. I use the lower band 10,300, okay, and upper band I use it 11,600. So you can change the strike also to see how actually the strategy is seeing. So you come to know in how the strategy will be moving on at various time frame, various point. So at 11,300, what is the profit we are seeing? At 11,500, what is the profit we are seeing? At 11,000, what could be the loss we could have? So this is our max. This is like a worst loss in during this time period. as it goes lower, we see our losses reducing. So this is the way you can use it. So now if you do this strategy only for say 5 days, so 5 days, and if you are very strong about the index momentum or you are very strong about the stock momentum, so you can use this strategy because it gives you a net long thing. You are protected on the downside, but still you can be aggressive on the upper side. Correct? So this is good from when you are taking a bullish bet on the any stock or on the indices. So let's come up to the next strategy. Okay, so post the call ratio back spread, we'll be discussing the call butterfly spread. So in a ratio back spread, we wanted the vol to be going higher. The implied volatility preferably should be on a upper end only, or else there should be a very strong up move in the underlying prices. So these were the two conditions which were there for the ratio back spread. Now I am a risk averse person. I don't want to take a very high risk. Still, I want to protect myself or take a directional bet. So now butterfly spread can act in both the ways. So now say for instance, I'm playing a bullish one. I want to be bullish. So in that case, I can set the butterfly spread with at the money, I will buy. Second, I will sell, and third, I will again buy. But placing of the spread is what is the key. Okay. Now, so why I call it as a range bound to bullish one? Because butterfly can take, you can use butterfly in both the cases. It only depends upon which strike you are buying and selling. Now if you are very bullish, okay, now you want to say that I am bullish on market, I am looking bullish on the stock. I feel there is a potential of a stock to go up to say 10%, but beyond which it is difficult for the stock. Because we always see a resistance coming up, we always see that this could be a likely resistance. Market has gone up so much, at 11,500 could be a breather, something. So you can devise your strategy based on that. So now what one thing is, there is something called as a modified call butterfly spread. The only difference between that is the strike difference. So in a call butterfly spread, you are buying one lot or buying one call. Say I'm buying 11,000 call, I'm selling 11,300 call, two lots, and I'm again buying 11,500 call. So here my strike difference between 11,000 to 11,300 is 300 points, and from 300 to 500 it is 200 points. So the strike difference is it's not the same, correct? So it is called modified call butterflies. However, if suppose my strike difference had it been 11,000, 11,300 and 11,600, it is a normal butterfly spread. So the only difference is that. So now when you want to take a bullish bet using a butterfly spread, so why you use a butterfly? Basically, you are expecting the volatility to be cool off or maybe be sideways. It may not rise higher, but it can be on a sideways because you are buying two option or you are selling two options. So you are actually you are trying to setting off the volatility impact. Okay, you want to play the direction, you want to play the price thing, and you are trying to set off the volatility one. So now in this one, when you are expecting a bullish one, you buy at the money, you sell two out of the money call, and you again buy one higher strike call OTM. So it the main benefit of a butterfly spread is helps you to limit your helps you making a limited profit beyond last strike also. So in a modified one, you have a only one break even point at times. So the second one will give you a stagnant profit. So also the butterfly spread has a higher reward to risk. So like you can get a spread at 3:1 also. Okay, or at times you can get at 2:1 depending upon how the walls are placed. That way your spread could change, but butterfly spreads are relatively higher reward to risk one. So you know what is your maximum loss, you know what is your maximum profit. Ideal from the beginner to intermediate trader, because as a beginner you should not be naked taking a naked option bet, writing option naked one, because you are gamma short. So once you get a good hang on that, you know how to come out of that part. If it's in a loss thing, how to repair your loss making strike, then that time you can definitely go about doing it. So what is the maximum profit? So maximum profit is made at the strike sold. So the in between, the one where you have sold two options is the point where you make the highest profit. Okay? It's completely hedged. So you have a defined loss, defined targets. Time decay is harmful if the stock is at the first strike. So in that case, your first strike option which you have bought will also lose the value, lose the time. But it is beneficial when it is at the option which you have sold. Because by the time the market comes over here, this option would have become in the money, right? So if I say 11,100, 11,300, and 11,500. If the market moves to 11,300, definitely my 11,100 option would have become in the money. So my time decay factor is very less. So I don't get impacted because of the time. But yes, my OTM option now is at the money. It's very sensitive to time. So here the theta decay plays a very good role. So this way your theta is also with reference to where it is placed, whether it is at the money, in the money, or out of the money. It's a beautiful study once you go in depth on understanding how the volatility impacts, how the time impacts. You actually come to know how you can make the best use of option in creating a strategy. So I use a modified call butterfly. So say I buy 11,200 call one lot at 134, sell two lots of 11,500 call at 43, and I buy 11,700 one lot of 20 rupees. So net net we have an outflow of 68 points, okay, and we have a target of somewhere around like a 230 points, close to that. Now let's evaluate it. So now I've taken two scenario. What if it was till 10th February, how my payoff will look, and on expiry how the payoff will look. So when I say you do any strategy, okay, so you always need to understand, like, will the profit which I'm seeing on the expiry, will I get the same profit during the expiry or during my evaluation date or no? So say for instance, on by 10th of Feb, this 11,500 call option, if my target achieves, the market comes, at that point I will make 6,000 rupees profit. Similarly, if the market were to go down, I will make a relatively lower loss also. So during the expiry, the butterfly spread payoff will not be the same like that of our expiry. It will be lower on the profit side and also lower on the loss side. Fair enough. But on expiry, you see that the time thing comes into picture. During the expiry, there's lot of the theta decay comes into picture. So the at the same point of 11,500, where it was 6,000 over here, now it is 16,000 on the expiry day. So this is what is the magic of the option, or this is what the crux of the option pricing is. So if you are very strong about the target of your index, if you see that the Nifty, say for instance, I'm just giving you a illustration purpose, don't take it as a recommendation, okay? So say for instance, we did 11,200 buy, we saw 11,500 and then 11,700 we bought it. Market moves to 11,500, okay? At that point the market is gyrating in the range of 400 to 600 in those point. So at that point, you need to sense of whether you're seeing the momentum to fade in. You see that the prices can correct, then you book your profit and you come out. But if you're very confident about the trend in the market, if you see that the broader market is performing, everything is falling in place, Bank Nifty is moving, your indices, large cap stocks are doing, then that time, if holding the strategy could be worthwhile because you are making almost three times what the profit it is. So butterfly spread, sorry, butterfly spreads really takes time to make money. You can sit with a butterfly spread throughout the expiry because the main cream money comes up on the towards the end of the expiry. So these, that's why you will see that in Bank Nifty, butterfly is a very common strategy people look out for. Because just 6 days, you see the expiry coming closer and closer. So you get the benefit of theta very fast. So if main money comes in the expiry week. But one thing is, it helps you to get a very good reward to risk. So if I have to see the reward to risk, so my max loss was somewhere around 5,000 and the max gain could be 16,000. So it's almost 3:1. So that's how the butterfly spreads are. In a modified one, why it's different? Because like if market were to go beyond 11,700, so from 500 to 700, your profit starts decreasing because your call option will start, the one which you have sold, 11,500, will start losing off. And then beyond 11,700, this buying option will cover up for one selling option. So you have this set off thing, you have the stagnant profit. So no matter what, at least I will come out in a profitable trade. So look at, you need to look up for your strategy, need to see, holding on to one day, what is my theta gain? Holding on to one day, what is my vega gain or loss? Because once you understand those concepts very well, you can play with the option beautifully. Manager, my positions. Yeah. So this was the strategy I entered yesterday. Okay. So you see that here the Greeks are comfortable. So like it's neither too high or low. You see the delta is 8.9, theta is minus 8, gamma is very negligible positive thing. So you can go and sleep properly. So if you are not a risk taker, want a good hedge strategy, butterfly comes beautifully in that place. So it's well positioned in that one. So if you have seen like, since yesterday and today, these are the prices. 11,200, we made some money. 11,500, we lost it. And 11,700, we made it. So net, we lost marginally. Now, if I have to analyze it, this is from the expiry perspective. Now, if I pull it now. So say in next 5 days, if I were to look at the payoff, at 11,500, I will make somewhere around like a 3,500 rupees, okay? And if it goes to 10,900, we'll lose somewhere around like a 1,800. So it's somewhere like a 2:1, correct? Now, if I increase the days, as I increase the day, my profit will also increase it because my time is playing now, coming in handy. Now, walls, if I increase or decrease, if I decrease the wall, so I'll make money, okay? If I increase the wall, then I am losing out on that front. So the wall, you can play around with the wall to understand how the wall will have a sensitivity on your option. So if you see that the walls have spiked up so much, it can come back to normalcy, then it could be helpful with doing this strategy. And it gives you a good comfortable zone. You can buy and you can hedge it also. So this strategy, trader use it both from the directional perspective as well as from the hedging perspective. So I'll go back to presentation. So now from the bearish perspective, is the same one, the put ratio back spread and the put butterfly spread. So the put ratio back spread is just, you can say, a mirror image of a call one, wherein the condition is the same. You're expecting the wall to increase. Secondly, you're expecting a very sharply the stock or indices to plummet, to fall down, okay? So in that case, there is a good momentum coming up, the good payoff, you can get it into put ratio back spread. So you sell one in the money put and you buy two out of the money put with a limited outflow. So the maximum profit is when the indices or the stock falls below the option which you have bought it. Okay, so it shows a very downward movement, so aggressively down you make a higher return. Your maximum loss is at the buy strike. So if the indices doesn't fall much and takes a support at your buying strike price, you tend to lose out the most over there. So say for instance, at same 11,110, I initiate a put ratio back spread by selling 11,050 put and buying 10,900 put. So sold at 160, bought 113, outflow was somewhere on 76 points, okay? So evaluation date, So this is how it is. So at 10,000, my maximum law 11,300. So here I am losing out somewhere around 5,000 rupees. But if the indices falls or the market gives a good correction out there, then in that case we tend to make money exponentially. So this is ideal one. I would rather say if you are having a very big portfolio, looking out for doing some strategy to hedge yourself. So it could be coming very handy because it helps you to hedge yourself, your portfolio on the lower end, but still it's not restricting your loss. So like your loss on the upper end is very marginal. So you can get a good reward to this in a put ratio back spread. Fair enough. So now if that as the days to expiry changes or as the vol prediction also increases or decreases, that's why your PNL will also change. PNL will also change. So if we go back, we can see the example. Okay, so now I have Nifty ratio put spread. Sorry, this one is different. So here put ratio back spread. So I have so 11,050 put, bought 10,900 put. So since yesterday, we are making 1,065 rupees in this spread. So you see that 10,900 gave us the money of 2,745 because the price has gone up. And in 11,050, we are losing out 1,600. So net net, we are making money. We are again gamma positive out here. I'm making a short strategy, so it has to be a delta short only. Vega would be benefit for me, like if the walls increases, then I will make money of 785 rupees. My theta is 204, so like a theta loss is relatively lower at the current junction. So these values also change across the as we move into the time. So they are not static, they are not stagnant, they are dynamic values. Go detail in into it so that we can get the crux of options. So if I have to do say 10 days, and if I we can change the range as we like, no barriers out there. Okay, and we can see if the market were to see this value, I won't say it. So you can see that you're making a good amount when the market corrects. So ideally, if you're having a bearish view on the underlying, apt for that cases. And secondly, if you want to take any hedge strategy, ideal for that too. Fair enough. So this is called put ratio back spread. So as you change the wall, as you change the time, you'll see how it will impact it. Do whenever you're doing any option, please use these parameters because they come very very handy and they are the heart of options. Wall and time are the heart of options. So if you get a hangs on that, you can really make a good money in the option trading. So this was the payoff. It's okay. Now comes the put butterfly spread. Okay, so it's 11,110. So at 11 we buy, 11 put butterfly spread is similar to a call butterfly spread. You're buying one at the money one, you're selling two out of the money, and you're again buying one out of the money. Okay, so in this case, say 11,000 put we buy 145, we sold 10,600 put two lots, and we buy 10,400. So basic crux here is that we don't look forward, then our market can correct beyond 10,600. Okay, so we feel that the max to max the correction could end towards 10,600. So we are selling two option out there, and then we are buying again at 10,400 so that our profit becomes limited. So if you look at the payoff butterfly as we discussed earlier, so the things doesn't change when we are saying about the call or the put. The basic essence of the strategy remains the same. So the butterfly spreads are more meant towards, like, it gives you a good reward to risk thing first. Secondly, it gives you a good holding power. So you don't need to be very anxious about squaring off the strategy, or you need to be like, let me square off one leg or second leg. One recommendation is, when you're a novice trader, when you're just started off, try to enter the strategy one time and exit the strategy at one time. If you start playing with the partially withdrawal thing sort of thing, then things can become complicated. Yeah, but once you have got good hands on that, if you are a advanced trader, you can use those combination to increase your profitability. So here, if you look at, if the market falls, we get a good return out here. Okay, our max profit would be at 10,600, somewhere around like a 24,000, and our max loss would be somewhere around 5,000, beyond 11,000. If it goes below 10,300, we are making a profit of 10,000, which is irrespective. So it's like a stagnant profit below 10,300. So butterfly spreads are best suited if you're having a directional bet. Secondly, if you're expecting the wall to subside or be constant. Thirdly, when you're expecting you know that beyond good support and resistance in place. So when you know that this is a vital support area and this is the vital resistance area, then your strike selection becomes quite handy. So you saw in backspread, I was making higher money. In butterfly, I'm not, because butterfly will give you very slowly profitability. So it will not give you loss also overnight. It will not give you a tremendous profit also overnight. It's something which you need to hold on till expiry to actually reap in the main money. You are delta short 15. Your gamma is very small. Your vega is 157 and your theta is minus 40. So like if one day passes by, you lose 40 rupees. A percent increase in vol can give you 157 rupees. Fair enough. Now let's analyze. So by default, the expiry one, I change it to see if my target comes, say, in 13 days. So in 13 days at 10,000, somewhere on, 10,600, I'm making 9,700 rupees. At 10,700, I'm making 7,000 rupees. Okay. Now my risk on the upper hand, if it goes to 11,300, it is 3,000. So like after budget, if you feel that the market is still in the uptrend only, so square off the strategy, because my motive was to take the protection on the lower end. And if you see that the momentum is strong on the upside, we can square off at a relatively lower loss. Secondly, if you feel that if the market has given a breakdown and you see there is a good risk that's going towards 10,900, 700, hold on to the strategy. So you can take your call without getting panic. So you don't need to just come up on the first Feb post budget, just you need to square off your strategy. It's not that way. You need to hold on to your option when evaluate your option strategy. See in the strategy manager on first Feb, how is your payoff looking? If I hold my strategy for 2 days, how will my P&L behave? If I see that the walls are falling, if the wall falls by 35-40%, how will my P&L move? So evaluate your strategy before squaring off. At times, squaring off early makes sense because you will be on the loss territory. But sometimes holding on to the strategy also makes sense. So rather than evaluate and then take a decision, which has to be a good one. Trainers, I hope everyone is with me. I know the content is little higher, but best the option is everything about the strategies. So the best use of strategies you can do, you can make money. Believe me. So this was what we were discussing on the directional one. Now comes the volatility trading. So volatility plays a very crucial factor before event. So if you see that automatically compared to December, the Jan month itself has seen, you had the result seasons, you have the budget which is in the Feb. So Jan itself has seen a surge in volatility, right? Because during event, there is always the risk of that uncertainty, okay? Because of which the volatility increasing. So now first thing is like when you're deciding on which strategy you have to take, you need to understand whether you're taking a bet on rise in volatility or fall in volatility. Also, are you looking at the strategy up till 1st Feb, up till the event date, or you're taking the call post? Means like whether whatever comes or no, I will square off that thing on 1st Feb. It's one type of strategy. Secondly, you want to stay in the position and take the you can say sound decision. So now first we have to understand whether we are expecting the volatility to increase or decrease. Say for instance, we expect the volatility to rise. Say the vols can go higher, say 22% or something. At that times we do a long straddle. Okay, so long straddle is a volatility strategy that aims to make money either ways. Okay, this strategy, the example which I have used is for Nifty, but you can use it for the stock option, you can use it for the bank Nifty. The main thing comes is your analysis, whether you are expecting the vol to go higher or the lower. Now, don't go and do the long straddle for something which is at a very high vol. So say for instance, the stock implied volatility is quoting at 80%. That time doing a long straddle could be playing adversely for us because the fall in volatility can kill away. So in that case, you need to first see what is the implied volatility which is there for the option. So you can see it very well in the option chain. You can see the strike wise, the entire implied volatility of the option, and then you can take your decision. Okay. So you execute the straddle by buying the at the money option call and put. So that is called the straddle. So when you buy at the same strike call and put, it is called the straddle. When you buy at a different strike call and put, it is called the triangle. Okay. It's not idle when the it's ideally for when the expiry is far off because the theta is not playing against us. So being directional neutral, so one positive thing is in the straddle is you're directional neutral. You're trying to play the volatility. There is no bias or bullish or the bearish any side. So you are taking the bet, you are buying both the options. But one thing you expect is a very strong momentum to come up. So basically, if you expect that the index can go higher by 4-5% or go lower by 4-5% in the Feb series, ideal in those scenario. Okay, if the underlying doesn't move, then it can result into a good losses because you're buying both the option. So now again comes the time factor. So you take the strategy as you move into the expiry. If you see that the profits are coming, you can book your profit or then you can take a call on it. But if you see that the momentum is strong enough, then you can hold on because one of the option will become almost, it can approach to the OTM level, it can come to very small value, and you are left with the one long which would be in your favor. So it depends upon the market condition how you play your bet. So say for instance, I buy 11,100 call and put for the Feb series, combined premium and say 365. Okay. So my break even point is now 11,465 and 10,735. So now this break even point comes into perspective when we are looking at the expiry payoff. But when you are at the start of the expiry, this break even point doesn't come into context. Because say for instance, tomorrow if a index see a 2% jump, in that case you will make money. Even though it is not at 11,465, 11,300, still you will make money because the time is not working against you. Spike in wall is adding to your gains. So when you look at the payoff, say there were 17 days left for the expiry 9. So at 11,100, we make a loss of 10,000. If the market goes higher to if the market goes higher to 11,500, we make a profit of 8,000. If the market goes to around 10,650, we make a profit. So we lose out only if the market is at 11,100. Now same thing if you look at from the expiry perspective. So here you look at the same point, 10,650, I'm making 5,000 rupees, but my maximum loss is now higher, 30,000, because of the time. Both the option and expire worthless. So my entire outflow of 365 rupees is being taken up. Okay. Here you still have the time value left in those options, so your loss is relatively lower. So long straddle, long triangle is apt when you're expecting the volatility to increase. Secondly, you are expecting a very strong either ways direction to come up. So you are not taking a bet on the direction, you are taking a bet on the momentum. So it could be, say for instance, in say in February, you expect either a 4% or 5% jump higher end or the lower end, suited for those type of thing. So if you look at the payoff, yeah, so Nifty straddle. So it's just we created this strategy on 24th, so like in the morning it was being created. So yesterday's price it is. So in this we are delta short of minus 0.86. My theta is minus 485 because I'm at the start of the series. Okay, I'm doing for the Feb series, so at the start of the series, so theta is not very high. But Vega, so like 1% increase in vol can increase my profitability by 1800 rupees. So that what it happened in the today's session. Since yesterday and today we saw the implied volatility inching higher, correct? So as you can see from the India VIX also, and also the implied volatility, you saw the vols were increasing in today's session. So when the vol increases, it increases both for the call as well as for the put. Okay. So in just one day, we saw the profitability coming of 3,106. Now let's analyze it. So this is the properly a game of volatility. Okay. So if the vols are increasing and if there is a directional momentum coming up either ways, then you can make a good money in the straddle. But the condition is don't buy at very high vols. So like it, normally the caution is from the stocks perspective. Say for instance, you do it pre-result where the vols have shooten up to 70%. You expect that the stock will give you 5 to 8% momentum. But will it be sufficient to set off that vol impact? Ideally not. So long straddle, long triangle is not recommended for very high volatility stocks. Because at that point, your risk, because one thing is very, you know, it's very much sure about is like a post event once the volatility subsides, because there is what was uncertain is now a certain thing. So you pay for uncertainty more rather than you're paying for something which is known to you, right? So once the event is out, mostly the walls fall. Thereafter, it takes the direction of the momentum. So if you see that the prices are falling, that time the implies are having a negative relationship. So when the prices fall, implied volatility of the put increases. So that's why you get a good momentum push on the lower end. Okay. But on the higher end, very rarely you see that post event the walls are increasing and the calls are increasing. So that's not the true so far. So when you're taking a bet on the volatility, understand like how much time period you're looking out for. So say for instance, after 12 days, at 11,100, I'll be losing 4,000. At 10,650, we'll be making somewhere around 10,000. And 11,500, we'll make 10,000 rupees. Now, if the wall falls, at 11,100, we'll lose almost 11,000 rupees. And our break even is also now higher, correct? Now if supposedly the wall increases, so you can see that I'm not losing at 11,100 also, because I'm the loss in the delta, or you can say the loss in the direction part is taken set off by the gain in the Vega, the gain in the volatility. Okay, so that's the reason why the volatility, always look, evaluate your strategy from the volatility perspective also. create. So this is one of the strategy, long straddle, long strangle, wherein you are betting on the upside on the volatility. But when you are having on the lower end, so when you go on the home page, when you go on the e-learn section, go to strategies, and here there are all type of strategy whichever is there in the algorithm. So you can read about it when you're bearish, when you're expecting a volatility, how you can play, when you're expecting the oscillation, how you can play. So in an oscillation, you can do a iron butterfly, condor. So those were little advanced, so I didn't took up in this one. But you can read about it in detail, and if you feel, you can take an example via this also, and so see how it will perform. Okay. So this way you can play in for the oscillation strategies also, where you are expecting post event the walls could cool off, then you can take something which is hedge strategies. Now then comes hedging portfolio pre-budget. So you often see that the investors who are holding on to the position for a long time get skeptical during the budget season. They tend to book profit in your trade, or they can lighten up their positions. Similarly on the future side also. So you will be having a bet on the future wherein you are quite confident, but you want to protect yourself from the downside. So you exit it and you think that post budget I will re-enter. But you can definitely hedge your portfolio. So what does a hedging means? Hedging against investment risk means strategically using instruments in the market to offset the risk of an adverse price movement. So when you are long on the market, you get risk when the market falls. Correctly? Similarly, if you are short futures, that time your risk is if the underlying goes higher. So the adverse price movement, you try to offset that risk. In other words, the investor hedge one investment by making another. So you are long, so you are taking another investment which is on the short side to hedge yourself. Technically, to hedge, you would invest in two securities with negative correlation. So when I say I'm long on the future, I'm positive bias. When I buy a put, that is an inverse thing. So it is negatively correlated. So that's how you take it. So hedging is something which you are trying to offset your risk by taking a contradicting position in the another instrument. So how you can do the hedge? By plain, you can buy a put option, you can sell a call option, or you can do a combination of buy a put and sell a call. So see how the payoff will look. So when you are long future, I bought something at 11,110. My payoff is completely linear. So if the price goes to 11,200, we make 100 points, that's 7,500. If the price goes to 11,000, we lose 100 points, we lose 7,500. So it's completely linear. Can you see? So here the time doesn't play a major role. The time is immaterial. So the difference between the future is just the basis thing comes, the premium and the discounts increases or decreases. But as such, it doesn't get impacted because of the time value. Okay, so it's very linear. It's something which you are on the underlying side. So you have an unlimited profit or unlimited loss. So this is something which is a long payoff. But now if I try to hedge myself, so what I do? I have a long future at 11,110. I buy a 11,000 put at 145. So how my payoff will be on 9th Feb? So I buy. So here if you look at, my loss is getting reduced. If you see the difference between this graph and this graph here, my loss is increasing exponentially as the price is going down. But here my steep, the loss is now starting getting constant. Okay, beyond this you will see a same loss everywhere, but on the upper hand I'm still participating on the higher end. So I'm not restricting my upside, I'm restricting my downside for a cost, that is my premium outflow. So here say for instance 11,100, when you are having a naked future at 120 you'll make money, okay? But when you buy a put, your break even point shifts. So rather than 11,110, your profit would be somewhere around 11,250. So once the Nifty moves above 11,250, you start making money. Okay, beyond that, it's the same thing. You make exponentially, but the lower end, now your loss is capped. Now, the third type could be like you're doing a long future, long put and short call. So when you're having a put option, there is an outflow for you. So that 145 rupees outflow. Now if the person says that okay, I don't want to take such a high outflow. Also, I don't expect that the prices will go beyond a particular resistance point. So it could be say 11,500. I don't see a prices going beyond 11,500. Or for the stock, I don't see it going beyond 15%. So I sell a call option of that strike price to reduce my premium outflow. Okay, so here I am now restricting myself on the upside as well as on the downside. So main reason is like you don't want to go in for such a high outflow. So when you take a combination of a future, long put and a short call, your payoff looks something like this, wherein like you have a defined loss and a defined profit. So there is no case of exponentially the price going higher or the lower. So you have a defined thing, completely hedge. So let's see all the scenarios here on our app. My position. So here is my Nifty long future. So Nifty were flat, so nothing majorly happened out here, completely flat. So main game was of the vol, the implied volatility shootout. So that's the reason we made money in the straddle strategy. But long future you look at is completely sideways. So this is the payoff. Even if I reduce my days or increase my days, it will not get impacted. I increase the vol or reduce the vol, doesn't get impacted because the future is linear payoff. Very simple. So if I'm long, the lower the Nifty goes, I'm on the you can say I have a very high losses coming up on the lower end. Similarly, if the index goes higher, I have an unlimited profit zone. So it's from the high risk perspective. Preferably, people don't like to take such a trade during the event. You always try to hedge yourself. How you do it? You take a position. So this is something. Okay, this one. Yeah. So I have a future 11,110 somewhere 108 rupees. I buy a 11,000 put. Okay. In future we lost just 184 rupees, but in option 11,000 option we made 1400 rupees, mainly because of the spike in vol. So when you're long option, the vols are in your favor. This you can see from the Vega value also. So Vega is positive, which shows that the 1% rise in vol will increase your profitability by 900 rupees. Theta is very low, it's hardly 200 rupees. So if you analyze it, so 11 days, you see your profit is still on the upper end only, unlimited one, but your loss gets limited to 15,000-16,000, okay? And as it, if you look at say 10,000, so you see this point, your loss is capped. It is not that unlimited one. As the days pass by, that time your time value will decay because you're long option, so your time value will go on. So this way you can hedge your position by, if you are on the profit one, you're not getting worried because of the downside. So if say for instance, on the budget day, you see a momentarily downside. So you have your position intact with you. You say that after 2 days I will reevaluate. It is coming to the support area. It is rebounding, rebouncing from that area. So quite often in the stock, the high beta stocks, you get very skeptical and you try to square off your very good profitable trade also. So in that case, rather than squaring off the your trade, buy a put option beforehand so that it secures you from the lower end on the downside. And still you can participate on the upside. So this way you can use a hedge strategy.